Minister, since 2011, when I came into this Dáil, I have asked dozens of questions to your predecessor and yourself about what I believe to be the gross mismanagement that's going on in Dun Laoghaire Harbour Company, the enormous waste of money on crazy madcap plans that nobody ever asked for, the latest of which is a plan to mortgage the assets of Dun Laoghaire Harbour to get 18 million to build a cruise berth, and just a complete lack of accountability of Dun Laoghaire Harbour Company. So what I'm asking in this question is, now the Harbour Company is finally going to move under council control, can we have an assurance that in the forthcoming bill dealing with this matter, that it will be under direct council control? No semi-quango that is unaccountable, that is a law unto itself, that we can't get any answers about, under direct public control.
Minister.
Thank you, Deputy. The drafting of the Harbour Bill of 2015 now is nearly complete, and I will be seeking government approval very soon to publish the bill. The bill will provide the legislative basis to one of the National Ports Policy key recommendations, namely that governance of the designated ports of regional significance vest in more appropriate local authority-led governance models. As the Deputy is aware, the five ports of regional significance are Drogheda, your own port of Dun Laoghaire, Galway, New Ross and Wicklow. The bill is designed to provide legislative flexibility. It will not prescribe the model of transfer, but will allow for the most appropriate model of governance in respect of each individual company to be chosen. The optimal manner of transfer is one which finds broad consensus and agreement between parties. That actual transfer will be made under a later statutory instrument. The two models of transfer will be retention of the existing company structure and the transfer of the ministerial shareholding, or the dissolution of the existing company structure and the transfer of all assets, liabilities and employees into the local authority structure. Where the company structure is retained and the shareholding of that company transferred to the local authority, then the bill will provide for the amendment of the existing Harbour Acts to reflect that transfer. Obviously, under this type of transfer, there is a need to ensure the appropriate balance between the freedom and requirements for commercial port and council oversight. The bill will specify the differing roles of the executive and the elected members of the council in this type of arrangement. As an example, the bill will contain a section requiring chairpersons and CEOs to appear before the elected members to give account of their administration of that company if invited by elected members. Obviously, under the other method of transfer, the company is dissolved and the port will be administered as a functional area of a local authority.
Thank you. Deputy Richard Boyd Barrett.
I want to strongly urge for the latter. That's the point I'm making, because I've heard these two options for quite some time. The Harbour Company, the executive, the board needs to be dissolved. I estimate that the savings in executive salaries, in expenses, some of which were falsely claimed and never repaid, not to mention then hundreds of thousands wasted on crazy master plans that never came to fruition, that nobody ever asked for, and that would have been completely inappropriate anyway, and all sorts of other waste that I haven't got time to enumerate. It's just leeching money out of a harbour. It's run the harbour into the ground. We've lost Stena now, and now we have this latest crazy plan hatched by a so-called stakeholder group to mortgage the assets of Dun Laoghaire Harbour to the tune of 18 million to build a giant cruise berth for giant luxury liners. Planning permission has been put in by the council for this, and they have no business plan. Our councillor, Melissa Halpin, asked in the council in the last few weeks, can we see your business plan? They haven't got one.
Thank you.
I will show it to you sometime. This is the crazy stuff that is going on. The minutes of the little cabal that are hatching these plans. Sorry, they don't take minutes. We asked, is there minutes of any of your meetings? They go off in junkets to the United States. Have you any minutes? No minutes.
I come back to the deputy. I've called the minister now, please.
It has to be dissolved.
Minister.
Well, I think it's a real pity that you have to use language like cabal and leeching in relation to a group of people who are working within governance structures to secure a future for Dun Laoghaire Port and Harbour. I've already outlined to the Deputy the model under which a port like Dun Laoghaire will be integrated into the local authority. And the manner in which that integration will take place will be a decision that I will take. I have the greatest of respect for the work that Dun Laoghaire Port and their management are doing. They have faced many challenges in the past and are looking to put together a sustainable plan regarding how that port will be grown in the future. And as I've said to the Deputy, the way in which that work will be integrated into the local authority will be made in the manner that I've just outlined to you.
Thank you. Deputy Richard Boyd-Barrett.
Let me just tell you, and I'm very serious about this, there's a rebellion taking place in Dun Laoghaire. There's one public meeting this week, packed, absolutely overwhelming anger against this latest plan. Save Our Seafront, the group I'm involved in, is having another one tomorrow, which I think will be absolutely packed, where protests are almost certainly going to follow. Because of extraordinary anger at the fact that it is a cabal. I mean, what do you call a group of people who are accountable to nobody, three people, who meet, who don't take minutes, who go off on junkets, who come up with plans that will have a massive effect on the harbour, potentially threatening with privatisation because it involves mortgaging the assets, and they don't take minutes for the meetings, and then when you ask questions about what they're doing, you're told, we're not giving you the answers. We're just not giving them to you. Right, that is what is going on. Now, that is not acceptable. And when you look at the state the harbour is in, it's lost Stena. We've had, as I said, hundreds of thousands lost on master plans that just dissolved into thin air. Crazy stuff.
Thank you, Deputy.
Right? So what I am saying, Minister, in the interest of democracy and the best interest of this important public amenity and the Dun Laoghaire area generally, is if we should dissolve the harbour board and bring it under direct public control, where there's real accountability and genuine public input into the plans to develop and protect this harbour as a unique public amenity.
Thank you. Minister, to conclude.
Thank you. Deputy, your language of describing groups of people as a cabal is unacceptable. This is a group of people. Deputy, you know, what I'm struck by is whenever I do make a genuine attempt to respond to matters that I accept of interest, the colour of your language just increases and the pitch of your voice gets higher. Okay? These are important matters that need to be dealt with. It is very, very important, and I've said this in the House already, that an acceptable plan and a secure plan is developed for the future of Dun Laoghaire Port. There are a group of people at the port who are working very hard to deliver that, and I've outlined how I'm going to deal with their integration in the future. But as I have said, regardless of any views in relation to the plan that they are proposing, I do believe your language is inappropriate in terms of how you are describing them, and I will be looking at the model that I've described, and I'll make a decision regarding how they're integrated into the local authority.
Thank you, Minister.